It happened around 3:45 on Highway 75 near Cornhusker Road. KATV Newswatch M's Brandi Peterson is here live in the news. But Brandi?
Well, the vehicle had a steep drop before crashing into a chain link fence. Witnesses say within seconds smoke was coming from the car and they knew they had to act quickly. Rescue crews worked quickly to douse the flames in this car.
He was driving his car in the grass up here, and all of a sudden, I just lost sight of him.
Bob Gilbert watched the car careen off Highway 75.
Pulled off to the side of the highway and came down, called 911, and his car was already smoking on fire and stuff there.
In a matter of seconds, Bob was trying to pull the driver out, and more than a dozen others were at his side.
Saw a lot of smoke coming out from the vehicle. We ran down there and there was a guy in there. He was trapped and the vehicle was on fire.
15, 20 other people were pulling down fences and pulling on doors.
We were tempted to use my shoes at one point because we couldn't get anything to bust the window.
I forced the door open and then me and another guy pulled him out. By that time the ambulance came in the fire department, and then the car sort of not blew up, but it caught on fire. If we got him out another five minutes later, he would have been gone.
Paramedics took the driver to a hospital, leaving behind this charred metal car frame and a group of strangers realizing what they had just done.
You do what you have to do. There was somebody in there. What are you going to do if you're on the scene of an accident and you don't get them out because you just don't want to, or you're too scared and they end up dying? What are you going to tell their families?
And several of the people we talked to had training for emergency situations. One had EMT experience. Another was in the Navy Reserves.
So fortunate that they stopped. And Brandi, any word on the driver?
Well, Rob, no updates tonight, but at the time, witnesses said the driver was conscious and talking when they pulled him out, and he was taken to the hospital in critical condition.
All right. Thanks, Brandi.
You're welcome.